In this and the next unit, we will learn what the so-called Bravais lattices are all about. We already learned that there are seven crystal systems. They are related to the seven so-called primitive lattices. Here, the seven primitive lattices are shown. They are called primitive because they are indeed simple. The lattice points are only at every corner, but not inside the unit cell or at edges or faces. And this means that such a primitive unit cell comprises exactly one base or motif. Note, not one atom, but one completely base. This also means that the primitive unit cell of a given crystal system is automatically the smallest possible unit cell. Because our whole crystal is built by sticking unit cells together, the unit cell must comprise at least one base. And it is always possible to find such a primitive unit cell. A short comment on the trigonal crystal system. Perhaps you may wonder why the trigonal crystal system is represented by two possible primitive lattices, although you learned that the trigonal crystal system has the same metric, the same lattice parameters as the hexagonal one. And this primitive trigonal unit cell does indeed not look like this one over here. We will explain this issue in a later unit. In this unit, we want to answer the question if the smallest unit cell is always the best choice, or in which cases it might be better to choose a larger unit cell. And this will lead us to the so-called centerings and thereby to the 14 Bravais lattices. So let's start. Here you see a pattern of lattice points. Which unit cell would you choose? Well, probably this one, shown here in blue. This is a primitive unit cell. There are lattice points only at the corners. Another equivalent unit cell would be this one, shown here in red. It differs from the blue one only by choosing a different origin. This is also a possible unit cell, because it fulfills the condition that by pure translation operations the whole lattice point pattern can be generated. If you actually have chosen this or that unit cell, you have chosen intuitively an appropriate unit cell for this point pattern. There are more possibilities to choose a unit cell. For instance, those unit cells shown here in green. Now we have five different but fully equivalent unit cells. But nevertheless, the blue one is the best choice because of the following rules. Firstly, the unit cell should be as small as possible. And this means the lattice vectors should be as short as possible. Secondly, the unit cell should also represent the symmetry of the lattice. And this means the lattice vectors should run parallel to symmetry axes or perpendicular to symmetry planes. This is the case for the blue and red unit cell because the lattice vectors run perpendicular to mirror planes of the lattice. But this is not the case for the green unit cells. We will discuss symmetry planes and other symmetry elements in more detail in the following units. Another rule for choosing an appropriate unit cell is that the axis should be orthogonal or hexagonal. This is indeed the case for the blue and red one. Let's switch to another case, another lattice point pattern. What kind of unit cells can you choose here? Well, there are, for instance, a few possibilities to choose primitive unit cells. This over here, or that one. But as you can see, whatever primitive unit cell you choose, they are all skew. The angles are not 90 or 120 degrees. Well, but there's the rule that the lattice vector should be, if possible, orthogonal. Are you able to find a unit cell which is in accordance with this rule? Yes, there is a possibility if we choose not the smallest unit cell, but instead this one. This is a centered cell. There is an additional lattice point inside the unit cell, here at the center of the unit cell. Choosing this unit cell has the advantage that we can now describe the crystal in a higher symmetric system of coordinates. The lattice vectors are now orthogonal. Does this mean that the crystal lattice changes its crystal system from, say, monoclinic to orthorhombic? Of course not. The symmetry of the crystal cannot be changed, whatever unit cell you choose. The crystal system is an intrinsic property of the lattice. So, this means that the primitive unit cell and the centered one have the same symmetry. Look, there are two symmetry planes, no matter what kind of unit cell you choose. However, this symmetry is much better represented by this centered cell with the lattice vectors running perpendicular to the mirror planes. We will intensify these centering aspects of unit cells in the next unit. Sometimes it is not easy to find an appropriate unit cell according to the rules we spoke about. And as an optional exercise, you can try to find the smallest unit cell of the following lattice. You will find a link to instructions right next to the video.